Before we get started on this video, I just want you to take this as a trigger warning for discussions of rape and sexual violence. Now, this is something I have touched on before when discussing the uproar over the rape scene in Hotline Miami 2, which took place in-universe as part of filming. Now, I won't go over my points on that again here, but if you want to check that video out, there is a link in the description below. However, the topic of rape and sexual violence in video games has once again raised its head, this time with the upcoming Outlast 2. In this case, the game has been refused classification once again in Australia, as was the case of Hotline Miami 2, due to a scene of implied sexual violence. Now, I'm going to read out their decision here, but again, take this as not only another warning for the discussion of implied sexual violence, but also a spoiler warning as well. So if you are sensitive to spoilers, I would avoid this particular section, skip maybe a minute or so ahead, as it does describe a scene fairly accurately within the game. Quote, in one cutscene in the game, a female creature prepares Blake for a ritual. She says, I want to see your true face, your seed will burn this world. Shortly afterwards, he objects to having psychoactive dust blown in his face, yelling no, no, before he stumbles into a forest clearing. His vision blurring, he witnesses what appears to be a ritualistic orgy. His wife, Lynn, calls out for his help, saying, it hurts, as she hangs from chains on a raised platform at the front of the clearing. Humanoid creatures, their skin grey, splattered with blood and scarred, implicitly have sex as others pray or chant or gesticulate. One creature has another bent over a rock, thrusting as they implicitly have rear entry sex. Another sits astride the pelvic region of another creature prone to the ground, moving their hips rhythmically as they too implicitly have sex. Two other pairs of creatures in the clearing are also implicitly having sex. As Blake yells for the creatures to get away from her, a female creature, her greyish breasts bared, pushes him onto his back, holds his arm to the ground, and repeatedly thrusts her crotch against him. As Blake protests, saying, no, stop that, the creature thrusts again before placing its face over his midsection and then sitting up and wiping its mouth. Although much of the contact between the creature and Blake is obscured by taking place below screen, the sexualized surroundings and aggressive behavior of the creature suggests that it is an assault which is sexual in nature. The board is of the opinion that this, combined with Blake's objections and distress, constitutes a depiction of implied sexual violence. In the board's opinion, the above example constitutes a depiction of implied sexual violence and therefore cannot be accommodated within the R18+ rating. Okay, so, with that out of the way, and if you are skipping ahead, you're safe to listen now. There is definitely implied sexual violence here. Definitely not going to argue with that. The fact that the scene is also implied to be a hallucination doesn't really change that either. But of course, it does matter very much to the context of the scene. As I argued in my Hotline Miami 2 video, context absolutely matters, no matter the medium. A rape scene just thrown in because lol's so shocking is a lot harder to defend artistically than, say, the almost rape scene or Perfect Blue, or the other untold rape scenes in other films that are fitting for the context of the film. You know, I could sit here all day listing them. You know, look at Irreversible. It's a very good film. Hard to watch, but a good film. Anyway, my issue here is one similar to that I had in my nudity in video games discussion. Video games are, once again, being treated as lesser than film. It is again somehow okay to show a guy's head being blown off with a shotgun or body parts sliced off with a chainsaw, and to show the untold violent acts we take part in almost every video game ever. But the second anything even vaguely sexual is involved, all of a sudden out comes the finger wagging. If a game wants to touch on hard-hitting topics or subjects that are difficult to watch or hear about, then in my opinion they absolutely should. You know, video games can be art, as I've said before, and even if they weren't, they're still within their rights as a medium that is rated and, you know, rated appropriately for adults or not, allowed to touch on these topics. And they absolutely should receive the appropriate rating for that. I would have absolutely no issue with Outlast 2 being released with a warning that said something to the effect of, this game contains scenes of implied sexual violence, but being told, oh no, 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 we can't have that. It's quite frankly annoying. The absolute disgusting travesty of a film that is A Human Centipede gets a public showing in cinema, but Outlast 2 kind of implies sexual violence without getting shut down by censors. Now, of course, there are several films that were banned or shown very, very later on from their release due to rape scenes and other implicit sexual violence. So I'm not cracking up the violins and saying that this only happens to poor old video games, but it definitely seems like it happens more. And the fact that it's still happening in 2017 is baffling and frustrating. And despite the meminess of the LOL current year argument, you can still get where I'm coming from here. Again and again, despite gaming bringing in untold billions and, of course, still being taken more seriously as an art form, it is still being held in low esteem by governmental bodies, classification authorities and censors in comparison to film. I'm fully aware that rape is, of course, an extremely touchy subject, but who are we to say we can't show that when it falls within proper context, reasoning and, of course, guidelines? In my opinion, better just to throw in a warning, and whoever doesn't want to see it won't. But once again, Australia are showing us, not only are they still behind the times when it comes to the classification of video games have a long way to go before they truly would be allowed to express themselves as an art form. At the end of the day, I'm not going to get myself in a tizzy over the fact that Outlast 2 has been refused classification in Australia. I'm sure Australian gamers who want to play the game when it finally releases this year will find ways around it, but it's still incredibly frustrating to me as someone, of course, cares very much about video games. It is my passion. Unsurprisingly, I wouldn't be here if it wasn't, obviously. And I fully believe it is an art form, and that, you know, it's okay to have a silly fun game, it's okay to have something in the middle, it's okay to have a dumb shooter where you just blow things up, and it's also okay to have a hard-hitting video game that discusses topics that are, you know, a central part of the human existence. Unfortunately, sexual violence is one of them, and films have very much touched on that topic and other very difficult to discuss topics over the years and years and years and years, and video games, in my opinion, should be allowed to do the same thing. And of course, a game like Outlast 2, which is of course very much about horror, psychological horror no less, you know, it's fitting for the context, and the game doesn't have to be all about adult things and lol, so adult, so edgy, look how dark we are to touch on these topics. If it's appropriate for the context, then absolutely they should include that scene if it's part of their vision. And of course, I haven't played the game, but I have played the original, and of course have seen the description of the scene, and from what I can understand, it does fit very much within the theme of Outlast, and of course what I've seen of Outlast 2. So again, this shows that despite the loads of progress that we have made when it comes to how video games are viewed, we still have a lot of work to do. But of course, all of this is just my opinion. I want to hear your opinions on this. Let me know in the comments below. As I said, there is a link in the description below to not only my Hotline Miami video, but also the nudity in video games video that I referenced as well. Do let me know your thoughts on everything I've talked about today. Thank you very much for watching, and I'll see you next time.